Hey guys, welcome back to the Entertainment Lab. I'm here to give you a recap of Netflix horror show The Haunting of the House Hill. So without wasting time, let's enter inside the Hill House. And before that, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. At start, it is shown that Stephen Crane is an author known for The Haunting of Hill House, an autobiographical novel about his childhood experience while residing in the haunted mansion, along with parents Hugh and Olivia, and his younger siblings Shirley, Theo, Nell, and Luke. During their stay, the Crane family encounters paranormal occurrence and it is forced to flee without Olivia, who dies within the house, tormenting the rest of the family. Years later, Stephen used his family's traumatic experience to write his book, Straining the Bonds with Siblings. One night, Stephen returns home, whereby he sees Luke trying to leave with some equipments that were stolen from his apartment. When Stephen enters the apartment, he finds Nell there. While talking to her, Stephen receives a call from Hugh informing him that Nell went to Hill House and has died. Now Stephen realizes that Nell is a ghost. In childhood flashbacks, sometimes after Shirley and her family left Hill House, a funeral is held for Olivia and an initially distraught Shirley is surprised and in awe that the mortician was able to fix her mother. As an adult, Shirley is now a mortician who owns a funeral business alongside her husband, Kevin, and rent a guest house to Theo, who is now a child therapist. Shirley soon gets a call from Stephen, who informs her of Nell's death. Distraught and shaken, she requests that Nell's corpse to be brought to her and she embalms her sister herself. However, after completing the emblem, Shirley suffers a scare when she encounters a ghost from her past. Flashback reveals that Theo is able to perceive feelings from people and impression from the object when she touches them with her bare hands. Meanwhile, there is an incident with Luke in which he encounters a ghost that attacks him. Luke is upset that no one believes him, so Theo investigates and finds a hidden door leading to the basement. Olivia reveals to Theo that her grandmother are sensitive and gives Theo a pair of gloves to protect her hands. Afterward, Theo goes to the morgue, takes off her gloves and touches Nell's forehead. She then collapses and screams. Later, Theo opens up about herself to Trish. A flashback to their last night in Hill House reveals disturbing image when Theo touches her father on the way out, including Hugh and Olivia fighting and getting pushed up against the wall and hitting her head. Child Luke was frustrated because her family never believed him. He finds a friend named Abigail, who all of the family insist is imaginary. Luke claims a bowler hat his mother finds in the attic and wears it frequently. Luke and Nell have shared a twin thing since birth and each is able to feel the other's physical elements. Child Luke wakes up one night and encounters the spirit of a tall man that comes to collect the bowler hat from Luke. In present, Luke is mugged and wandering with the hatted man following him. The feeling of cold from the earlier is unbearable and Luke calls the halfway house to beg to be allowed back in. After which, Stephen informs Luke of Nell's passing, but Luke shakily states it wasn't suicide. Child Nell is tormented by a ghost she calls the Bent Neck Lady, a ghostly figure with a broken neck standing at the foot of her bed while Nell is unable to move. Adult Nell sees a sleep technologist, Arthur, for sleep paralysis and the two immediately hits it off. They become engaged, eventually marrying. During one sleep paralysis episode, Arthur suffers a sudden brain stroke, dying, while Nell sees a bent neck lady back again. In her broken state and convinced by her therapist that Hill House is just a carcass in the woods, Nell drives off to the house. She enters the house and encounters an idyllic scenario of her family and Arthur in a beautiful renovated mansion before finding herself at the top of the staircase, where she puts a noose around her neck while imagining it to be her mother's locket, before she is pushed from the ledge by her mother, breaking her neck. As she dies, she herself falls and travels through the past, revealing that she herself is the bent neck lady haunting her younger self, becoming a ghost of the house. Now there is an alteration between two storms, one the family experienced in the past at the Hill House, the other in the present, the night before Nell's funeral. With the entire Crane family meeting at the funeral parlor to view Nell's body, together in the same room for the first time since leaving the house. During the storm in the past, Nell goes missing. While searching for her, Olivia sees a spirit in the house and encounters a fake state, acting strangely and unlike herself. The children see a creature in the house. Nell is eventually found and she says she had been there the whole time, but they couldn't see her. At the funeral home in the present, an odd thing happens. Steve sees a flash of the ghost of his mother, then the power goes out. Something is interfering with the Nell's body, and Hugh sometimes seems to talk to himself. The family demands answer from Hugh about what happened, leading to several confrontation and revelation. Temper rises and argument ran nasty. This escalates until Nell's coffin falls over by itself, interrupting the fights. Nell's spirit had been in the room the whole time as they fought, although no one could see her. During the funeral, Hugh tries to reconnect with his children. In the past, accessing the house was storm damage. Mr. Dudley assists Hugh, revealing some history of the house's previous occupants. Mr. Dudley suggests that increasingly erratic Olivia needs to spend time away from the house, sharing some of the strange experience he and Mrs. Dudley have had and why they never come to the house at night. Hugh and Olivia agree she needs to spend time away when her behavior becomes disturbing and dangerous. Hugh discovers the source of the moisture and solves the disappearance of William Hill, the original owner. The ghost of Olivia appears twice, attacking Luke at the funeral and then Hugh and Theo in Shirley's office, also putting the buttons over the eyes of Nell's corpse. After that, Luke goes missing. Stephen and Hugh drive around to find Luke. Shirley and Theo stay at the funeral parlor to keep watch on whether Luke will use stolen credit card. Shirley gets a notification of Luke using the credit card for gas at the gas station on the way to Hill House. Hugh reveals to Stephen that while he was living in the house, Stephen had been seeing ghosts all along. He just didn't realize they were ghosts. He also explains that Stephen and his siblings are like unfinished meal to the house. So Shirley and Theo decide to drive up to the Hill House while continuing to argue with each other. Luke arrives at the Hill House and tries to burn it down, only to be caught off guard by the vision of Olivia and another ghost who incapacitates Luke. In the flashback, Hugh finds Olivia, Nell and Luke asleep on a couch and she tells him she wished the children could stay like that forever. When she walks through her reading room door, she enters the morgue containing the corpse of adult Nell and Luke, where Nell speaks to her. She wakes up in the middle of the night and encounters the ghost of Poppy Hill. The family's last night at the mansion starts to unfold as an unstable Olivia roses the twin of Abigail, who was staying over for the night for a tea party in the Red Room. Shirley notices her mother behaving oddly in the kitchen and awakes Hugh. He realizes Olivia had tainted tea with the rat poison and is able to intervene before Luke and Nell drank the tea, but arrived too late to save Abigail. Hugh gets the kids out of the house, leaving horrified Olivia behind, who dies when she falls off the top of the spherical staircase. Stephen and Hugh see Luke unconscious in the Red Room after failing to burn down Hill House. Stephen became locked in the room and awakens from the nightmare to find Luke near death as Theo and Shirley unconscious nearby. Awaken after experiencing revolutionary dreams about their lives. In Luke's dream, he arises inside a pristine room and finds Olivia, Abigail and a young Nell. Olivia wants him to stay, but Nell tells him to leave. He wakes up gasping and points to Nell's specter as having saved him. Nell explains that the Red Room is the stomach of the house and the room in which each of them had lived a personal fantasy. Before vanishing, she assures them that they had all loved each other completely. Olivia's ghost tells Poppy to stay away from Hugh. Olivia doesn't want her children to leave, but Hugh convinces her to open the door and let them escape. Hugh and Stephen stay behind and Olivia's death and its aftermath is revealed. The Dudleys were Abigail's parent and convinces the younger Hugh to keep the death of Abigail and how it transpired a secret. Hugh, who had died by now, enters the room and joins Olivia and Nell. 2 years later, the siblings, with the bonded reconciled, celebrate Luke's sobriety together with their partners. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, hit the like button, and for more such content like this, subscribe to our channel.